RobinReaction.com.
In this video, I'm going to go over a big stoichiometry practice problem. And so, if you're doing stoichiometry in class, these vocabulary words at the top are the most common ones that your teacher would expect you to know. And so let's go over a big practice problem that involves us using every single one of these concepts. And I'll go over each one as we get to it. So for right now, let's start here with our question, which reads 56.3 grams oxygen and 9.46 grams hydrogen reacts to form 27.8 grams water. Find the limiting and excess reagent, the theoretical, actual, and percent yield, and percent error. All right, so a ton of different concepts here, and let's just go ahead and follow our instructions in blue. This will tell us what to do. So number one, in all stoichiometry practice problems, something that usually gets told to students, but still it's just easy to make this mistake, make sure your equation is balanced. Can't tell you how many times I've seen a student do the entire problem, not understand what they did wrong, and I look back and that's the very first step, they just didn't balance their equation. So let's go ahead and do that. So to balance, we need to double the oxygens on the right-hand side. Now we have four hydrogens and two oxygens, which means we have to add a two here so that on both the left-hand side and the right-hand side, we have two oxygens and four hydrogens. All right, so next we're going to have to convert from grams to moles, because when we're comparing these ratios, we really don't care what the ratios of the grams are to each other. We only care what is that mole ratio, because remember, when we balance the equation, the numbers that we put here, the coefficients, these are all mole ratios. These have nothing to do with mass. So let's go ahead and line up all of our masses. And now we know to convert into number of moles, we're going to need the molar masses of both of these substances. All right, and now to get the number of moles, we need to divide our mass by our molar mass. All right, and just a quick note here, sometimes students make a mistake getting the molar mass because they see oxygen, they look it up on the periodic table and they say, oh, okay, its molar mass is 15.999. But remember, this is O2, we have to get the molar mass of this molecule, so instead of using the atomic masses we see on the periodic table, we're going to have to multiply both of them by 2, because we're balancing O2 and H2, not just O and H. Alright, so now we have our two numbers of moles, and you may have noticed that even though we are given 27.8 grams of water, I haven't dealt with that number yet. And that's because I'm going to start this problem by finding the limiting reactant and the excess reactant. You can also see up here in my definitions, I have reactant for one, reagent for the other. It doesn't matter, reactant, reagent, same thing. And so the 27.8 grams of water, that's a yield, which we'll deal with later. With doing limiting and excess reagent, we don't need to actually know how much we made because it's all about how much could we theoretically make. All right, so now it's time to figure out who's limiting and who's excess. And there's a couple of different ways you can do this. So one is to just pick one reactant randomly and say, okay, how much would this reactant need of the other reactant to be completely reacted? So in this case, we know that the ratio between oxygen and hydrogen is 1:2. So if we have one mole of O2, we're going to need two moles of H2. And so we don't actually have one mole of O2. We have 1.759 moles. So now, what if we multiplied that by 2? We'd get 3.5187 moles of H2 needed. So now we can actually look at our numbers of H2 that we actually have, and we can say we actually do have over 3.5 moles of H2. So this is going to be possible. And just to show you the other example, so again, if we had started with H2 and said, all right, the mole ratio is 2:1, so however many moles of H2 we have, we need exactly 1/2 of that for oxygen, and we say, oh, okay, we have 4.692 moles of H2, which means to find out the number of moles of oxygen needed, we just divide that, and we get that we would need 2.346 mole of O2 to completely use up all of our H2. So this, because we look over here, we only have 1.759. This option is not possible. So now looking at these two situations, we can see that using oxygen, we are able to completely run out of it and we would have enough hydrogen. That means that O2 is the limiting reagent. You can think of the limiting reagent as just the one that you run out of. And so in our situation on the right, we wouldn't be able to run out of hydrogen because we wouldn't have enough O2 to use up all the hydrogen, which means that hydrogen is our excess reagent. All right, so now looking at our problem back at the top, we have now the limiting and the excess reagent, and now let's find the yields. So one, we actually have, without doing any work, it was just the number that was given to us, the 27.8 grams of water. So this is just saying, hey, we did this reaction in lab, and this is just how much we made. It just is here. We ended our reaction and we had 27.8 grams of water. And so this just is the actual yield. So we have the actual yield. Check that off. And so you always just have to be told the actual yield. And just to get into the actual yield for a second, the reason why a lot of problems have it is because in real life, this wouldn't just be a word problem you're doing on a test or homework. This would be something you did in lab. And when you're in lab and you're actually mixing these chemicals, you just can't get a perfect reaction. You're always going to lose a little bit. It's kind of like if you're making a cake and you put all of your ingredients in the bowl and you make it and then eventually you take it out of the pan, there's always going to be a little bit left on the pan. Or you're always going to spill a little bit as you are stirring it and it's going to end up on the counter. You're never going to have 100%. Maybe you'll have 99.98% and you'll be extremely diligent, but there's going to be some amount that just gets used up or is spilled or something happens, you can't get it off a container, and then here you are. You have an actual yield, which is less than how much you theoretically could have made if you had used up all of your ingredients. So the actual yield, we don't have to do any math to get. That's it. Now let's do the theoretical yield. And so the theoretical yield is usually what students think about first when they think about yields. So this just means what it sounds like. Theoretically, how much of this could we make? How much water in a perfect world could we have made? And so if we had 100% success, if we didn't spill one molecule, how much water could we have made? And so what we need to use limiting reagent to find that answer. So pulling that down, we have 1.759 mole O2, and we're going to use all that up. That's our limiting reagent. And we can look at the mole ratio between O2. So remember, if it is invisible, if there's nothing here, it really means there's a 1 right here. And we look at the mole ratio of our product, which is water. So once again, we have 1 to 2. So to set up a ratio, our mole ratio is 1, 2, 2. So now, to go ahead and do the math, we don't actually have one mole, we have 1.759 mole. So once again, multiplying that by 2, that means in a perfect world, we'd be able to make 3.5187 moles of water. All right, so our theoretical yield of water is 3.5187 moles, but most classes are not going to let you give the theoretical yield in moles. They're going to request it in mass. So let's go ahead and convert this to grams. So for that, we're going to need the molar mass of water. And we can go ahead and multiply it by the number of moles of water that we know we could make in a perfect scenario. So our moles cancels out, and we end up with 63.37 grams. So this is our theoretical yield in the form that your teacher most likely wants it in. All right, so we are close. Now all we have is percent yield and percent error. And both of these are just formulas that we plug into. So in some ways, they're less conceptually difficult than what we've done before. All right, so our percent yield is just our actual yield divided by our theoretical yield times 100. Makes sense, right? We just want to kind of figure out what percent of what we could have made did we actually make. So plugging in, remember 27.8 grams just comes from what they gave us in the problem. 63.37 grams is what we just found to be the theoretical yield. So let's divide those and multiply by 100. And we get 43.9% as our percent yield. We made a chunk of what we could have made, but not even over half, not a great percent yield. And now let's do percent error. And so these are just absolute value bars. So we need to take our theoretical yield, subtract our actual yield, divide by the theoretical yield, and times it by 100. So plugging in, we get 56.1% as our percent error. So not a super successful reaction. We kind of had a big percent error in this one. All right, so at the end of every chemistry problem, we always have to do sig figs. Let's go ahead and do a check for that. So our sig figs are only going to come from the numbers we were given in the problem. So that means we have a limitation of 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. So we have a limitation of 3 sig figs. So looking at all of our answers, the first thing we were asked to do is the limiting reagent and the excess reagent. So there really are no sig figs for that. We just have to label what's limiting and what's excess. And the actual yield was given to us. That just had 3 sig figs. So all we have to adjust are the theoretical yield. And so that was right here. So I need to actually shorten my answers to only have 3 sig figs, which means this becomes 3.52 moles, and this becomes 63.4 grams. And then our percent yield and our percent error already have 3 sig figs, so they're good to go. All right, I hope this video helped you with some stoichiometry definitions and problem-solving skills. They're super complicated, so if you're just starting out, I have a bunch of different videos that go over each one of these concepts one by one, and good luck with your class.
Hey, I hope you liked that video. Please feel free to like, comment, or subscribe, and if you go to my website, I have a ton of free practice problems you can check out, and if you need even more help, you can hire me for one-on-one private tutoring sessions that are online. All right, thanks, that's it. Happy studying.